professional streamer. Thanks, Dan. Where was I? I have no clue. Anyways, yeah, so I got my Cessna 172 SP here. Like I guess, well, not that you heard, but custom paint job, if you will. It is hastily done, but it gets the point across, it gets the job done, and it looks better than, well, what was there. What I was saying was I've got a post out in the X-Plane forums asking if anybody wants to repaint this for me, and it's been up there since November, and nobody has taken the bait, so what have you. All right. Let's fire this thing up and take it around the patch, why don't we? Turn the alternator on. Let's put the mixture in. That trim's got to come way, way down. That is horribly high. You'd think it would default to something a little better, but no. Let's crack the throttle just a little bit. Fuel pump on, about 3 seconds or so. Down it goes, and let's crank it. And there we go. Let's turn on the avionics, beacon, nav light. That'll work for now. Current air temp, we got 56 degrees. I don't need the pitot heat. So throttle down to 10,000 or 1,000. There we go. All right, sanity check in the cockpit. We have annunciator check. Yep, that sounds good. oil temperature is in the green for now. That'll run up as we sit here for a while. Oil pressure's in the green. Vacuum's on the low side, as expected. Amps are in the green. That's a very tiny little green area. Fuel flow's looking decent enough. We have half tanks on both sides. We have wing tanks. I'm not going to bother with the avionics right now. We are just going to be putzing around the airport, basically. This is mostly just a test, just to see how my video card settings and X-Plane settings are conducive to streaming. It has been a while, but I think I'm getting things situated, you know? Alright, check, 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 check. Instruments look good. Alright. There we go. Check the controls. Goes up, goes down. Goes up, goes down. Ah, wrong button. Goes up, goes down. And behind me, I have a rudder. Yep. And we have an elevator. Yay! We can move! Parking brake release. Let's go. We are at Cedar Rapids, Iowa, also known as the Eastern Iowa Airport, KCID. I picked up this scenery package off of the explain.org forums. I was rather surprised to see this one here because, this is where I work. Not at the airport. We have a building at the airport, but I don't work in that one. I work in town. We'll taxi down to runway 9. There's a lot of hot air balloons out today. I am not using current weather at the moment. This is midday, broken clouds, or scattered. I think I picked scattered. It's a canned atmospheric scenario. Because right now, I look outside. Yeah, it's crap. It is total crap. I haven't checked the ceilings here, but I don't think I'd be flying today here. But this is a simulator. That's why we do these things. I can make the weather however I want. Let's taxi everywhere but on the line. How's that sound? That sounds good to me. This is a very long runway. There are, it's almost, like international airport sized, basically. I mean, it's got 4 carriers, I think, coming out of here. United, Delta, Allegiant, that sort of thing. So we have, you know, mid-sized airliners come in through here. A320s and 737s, CRJs, that sort of thing. And we're going to plop that right here, turn on the parking brake, and do our run-up. Mixture in, throttle up to 1800, 15, 16, 17, 1800. Now at this point, normally what I would do, the functionality, we'll say, is not in this model. Normally you would switch the key, you see it down here in the, where the key goes. There's off, R, L, both, and ignition. And then start down there at the bottom. What you would do is right now the key is on both here. That's using the left and the right magnetos, and you would switch between the left and then back to both, and then to right and back to both. And you're checking for an RPM drop. And if it's too much or too little, your mags are not really conducive to flying, and they probably need to be checked out. But I can't do that here, so we're just running through the motions. Claire, I can't change it. It let me change the title, but if I click on the game, it doesn't do anything. So, I'm D&D and X-Plane. I'm multitasking. Hold on, let me just cast Magic Missile into the darkness, and let's go. Clear right. Clear left. Oh, we're going to rocket into position here. Flaps up, mixture's good. Off we go. Roll initiative to take off, right? How you doing, Max? And 60 knots, rotate. Off we go. About 1,000 feet per minute. Most. Winds are calm. I'm not doing anything crazy here. Yet. Like I said, this is a test stream, if you will. Want to get a feel for how it looks, how it sounds, how it feels. So I know what I gotta tweak before I kick this into high gear. Do a barrel roll. At about 1,000 feet AGL, I don't think so. I don't think so, Max. If I had, you know, a couple more 1,000 feet, I might be able to do that. This is a 172. I think it would actually... I don't think it has inverted fuel pumps. Oil pump too. You gotta have a inverted oil pump too, because otherwise you'll kill the engine. And you don't really want that. Here. We'll floor it. And we'll get some of that altitude. And by the way, Iowa does look like this. This is generic scenery, but that's actually what it looks like. And directly off to the wing you have Cedar Rapids proper. As I'm banking towards it. That's not good. That would suck, yes. Slowing down. Pitching too high. Although if I do that, I could probably walk it. Pull it just a little bit more. Oop, too much. Don't stall. Don't stall. Kick the rudder in. And walk it on its tail. There we go. You can see the ground kind of going sideways below me. It's a level, wings level turn. Very slowly, but wings level. And I am climbing like a banshee still. Well, for a 172 anyways. And straighten that tail out. Head straight this time. so slow. But when you're climbing out like this, it's... yeah, there's a little bit of the airport still. Ah! Zoomed in. Wrong button. I have my keypad hotkeyed to different views. Like, let's see, we have that wing, in case I really need to squint in and see my controls, pilot seat, comm stack, nav comm stack. This one's good for starting it up because everything's out of the way. Down here I can check the trim, the lights, and passenger. There we go. Alright, 4,000 feet. Let's level off and get some airspeed. Won't take long. Come on. Trim down, trim down. No fuel pump. No fuel pump. La di da. I can try to do stall, flip, and whoop. And get it back, get it back. There we go. This is not an aerobatic aircraft in the least. Look, 4,000 feet, we can do stalls. So we pull the throttle back. Keep pitching up. So we slow down. Pitching up, pitching up. Keep pitching up. Stall horn in 3, 2, 1. One. There it is. And break. Come on, break. There. Point the nose down, get some airspeed. And you're good to go. So guys, how does the stream actually look? Is it crisp? Is it smooth? Is it jittery? I mean, mine's a little bit jittery just on my screen, but then again, I got, you know, all this stuff doing, so. Stuff going on. Airport's over there. I am awfully, awfully high. Stream good, audio a tad low. Audio a tad low. Mic audio or system audio? We have me, music, and X-Plane. Which one you want? Excusez-moi. Primarily Mike. Mike's low? Mike's low. Okay. Mike has been turned up. Unless you meant music's good? Good. Okay, mic is turned up. How's that? Any better? Is this any better? I hope it's better. Alright. Let's get radical. So, I'm pretty high. I'm about 4,200 feet. Field elevation is about 860 something, something like that. Way better? Good. So there's a couple of ways to lose altitude quickly. One is kill the throttle, put the nose down, and go whee! But as you see, your speed increases like crazy. And sometimes you don't want that. So sometimes, like when you're coming into land, you can do too much a slip. My controls are a little bit touchy. So I'm still flying straight, but I'm at an angle. Hey, Arctic! How's it going? So right now, the relative wind, what I'm flying into, is hitting basically the right side of the aircraft, and helping to keep its speed down. As you can see, my vertical speed there is pretty good, about 1,000 feet a minute down, but my speed's not increasing. There's a hot air balloon. I straighten up. I'm still at about 2,500 feet. And the airport's over there. Another thing you can do is S-turns. Oh yeah? Dreadnought, huh? Just lazy S's. Anything that, you know, increases your drag, obviously will slow you down. Alright, what am I at? 2,000? Should be good to go. Let's go ahead and turn in. You know what, let's get a notch of flaps in. That'll help too, now that I'm in the white arc there on the airspeed indicator. Now, one of the downsides to simulator, particularly a flight simulator, is when you're flying like this and you're approaching an airport that's up to the right, in the aircraft you can actually see where that airport is and kind of, you know, aim for it. Whereas here I'm just kind of guessing, and I did pretty good. There is a correct, yeah, Arctic, yeah. There's a program called Track IR, but it's only for Windows. It uses your webcam, and you can have markers wear a hat and put it on the bill, and there's two markers that the video camera will read and be able to move the screen according to your head movements. There's one for Linux, but there's a lot of compilation and command line configuration stuff that I do enjoy, but God, it takes a while to get it right. Not to do it. If you know what you're doing, it's real simple, but I don't really know what I'm doing with it. White over white, fly all night. We're a little high. There's two white lights to the left of the runway there. They're either Vazzies or Pappies. I can't remember which one they are right now, off the top of my head. But they indicate your glide slope. That's your touchdown point, hence you see all the tire marks. That's what you're aiming for. If it's red over white, you're dead on the glide slope. If it's red over red, you're too low. White over white, you're too high. But this runway is, you know, almost 2 miles long. I think I've got room, considering my stopping distance. Another notch of flaps. Slow down a little bit more. There, now I'm on the glide slope, which means I could pull up a little bit. And nose up. I'm not going to get a stall horn on this one. Not bad. Alright, flaps up. Flaps up. Flaps up. Full throttle, off we go. 60 knots. My trim is way off. Don't do this at home. Like, seriously. Tower won't be happy with you. Did I miss the tower? I missed the tower. Must have went right around it. But yeah, there's a Delta 717 ATR. Oh yeah. All the good stuff. Plenty of balloons out. But that's common in Iowa. Bearings, check the road. Okay, that's the road to the airport. Where's the highway? There's the highway. So this guy right here. So this is I-380. Directly off my nose. Big four lane highway. I'm going way too fast. But yeah, stream on my end. Well, I'm looking at OBS. Looks pretty good. So the street lights are not right. There's no street lights this far north. And I wouldn't call the road elevated here either. So one of the things that they teach you when you're learning to fly is if you have an emergency, like an engine now, one of the things you want to look for is like a highway or a field. Now, in Iowa, that's not hard to find a field. But a highway, you know, this can kind of demonstrate some of the hazards of trying to land on a highway. Traffic lights, signs, and hello trees. There are no trees there. Shouldn't be any trees there. Alright, so this is the 30 interchange. Alright, Claire, have a good luck. Have a good time on your paper. Thank you for stopping by. I appreciate it. Bye! So that's the crossing over US 30 back there. And that is a creek, not a river. There's another hazard, power lines. Words are hard. Words are very hard. Oh, especially given how rusty I am doing streaming like this. Oh, look, the road goes under the earth. It's a subterranean road there. That's awesome. GG X-Plane. That's awesome. Alright, let's get a little more altitude, so a little more speed. I've missed streaming Arctic. It's been a while. I've picked up the 8-bit stream every now and again. When Dav is unable. But that's streaming from, and there's the road goes under the ground again, and they don't care. The drivers just don't care. That's interesting. Not gonna question it. So here comes Cedar Rapids. There's a lot less buildings. I mean, Cedar Rapids isn't a big city by any stretch. But there's more than just that building right there. And this island right here that you see in the middle, it's actually, there's only, the way I understand it, there are two, like federal, not federal level, but like government buildings, on islands. That's one of them. There's supposed to be, all of Cedar Rapids, government is on that island. Or at least up until it flooded. And the off-ramps and the overpasses, I'm impressed, are really modeled correctly. Placement-wise, even the railroad tracks, looks like the correct number of tracks. That's impressive. Even the lake. So this lake right here, I found this interesting. And this is one of the things that I love about Iowa. This lake right here that I'm flying over, you can fish out of. But what's interesting is this whole island or this whole peninsula right here where the railroad tracks here come in, it's a big industrial area. Factories and all kinds of stuff are right here. And as you can imagine, they would dump their stuff. That is quite a bank turn. they would dump their stuff into this water, use this water, you know. But Cedar Rapids put some restrictions on them a long time ago, very proactively a long time ago, and they've been cleaning up the water ever since. And last year, I think it was last year, they actually announced that you can now eat the fish out of that lake. I don't want to, but I'm glad that I could. It's just neat to see that. Because most of the time you see government doesn't do anything about it. They just leave it there because the businesses make the city too much money, so on and so forth. So over here, ish. See if I can figure out that's center point. Not here, but in the back over here. Okay, that's those are buildings in the road. That's great. That's awesome. I think it's right here where these power lines are. I think that's where I work. There should be a building there. Nope, that's not it. Is this it over here? See, it's hard to tell. Yeah, this is it over here. So this, see that pond and this patch of trees? That's supposed to be office buildings, and that's where I work. Yep. Whee! There we go. Let's get back in the airplane, huh? It's not much of a simulator. If you're not in it, because you can't really get out of the plane if you're flying. Well, you can. I don't think you want to. Alright, Cedar River is there in front of us. What we're going to do is fly up to Vinton Airport. Just follow the river. Let's get there a little faster, huh? Alright, so we've got to trim up. Come on, trim, work with me here. Too much. Well, speed's increasing. When you trim the airplane and increase the speed at the same time, you're gonna have a hard time. Trimming the airplane is on your tail there in the back. Wrong one. Nope. There we go. On the elevator, there's an actual tab. So, if I can level out here. So you have the actual elevator that goes up and down like this. At the very tip, there's a little tab that will go, up or down. Up or down. And it's just to provide just enough deflection to help fine-tune your flying angle, we'll say. And you can raise or lower that without actually, lifting the elevator. But that setting essentially correlates to a particular airspeed. So, for example, I'm doing about 110. Excuse me, right, I'm climbing, though, but I'm doing about 110. So there's a certain position that the trim should be in or wants to be in when the airspeed's at 110. And if it's not in that position, it'll climb or descend until it tries to find that position. Problem is, when it does that, your speed changes. So, like, right here, you see I am trimmed, was trimmed, I'm close to being trimmed for what looks like about 115. I mean, I'm climbing and accelerating. I'm not at full throttle. I'm backed off a little bit. Alright. Let's head to the north a little bit. And like I said, this is what Iowa looks like. This is what Iowa looks like. In case you were wondering. Yeah, stream looks good. Because I tried this with my old video card sitting right there. and my 8 gigs of RAM. The sim looked like crap. I'll just say that. It looked horrible. I couldn't do, this isn't even, you know, the max density trees. This is decently scattered, I guess. I can actually put cars down. I can do mountain flights. I've not done any. All of my flight training has been done over completely flat ground. I flew mostly in Northwest Ohio, which is even flatter than Iowa. I didn't personally, you know, I wasn't piloting command down in Florida, but I did go up a couple times in Florida, and again, there's no real mountains down there either. The only time I've been around flying in mountains has been, you know, flying coach. But flying in mountains is different. There's a lot more to consider. Here, you're a little more, I'll say, relaxed than you would be mountain flying. Because your winds are going to be pretty straight here. They're not going to be curling over a mountain ridge. The weather's not going to surprise you. There's less likely to be fog showing up here. Broad fog, I guess, that covers the entire area. In the mountains, you can get very specific areas of fog that'll just pop up because of the way the air is and the terrain. So there's Vinton up in my upper left corner of the screen there. Small town on the banks of the Cedar River. There's an airport north of town. That's where I'm going to go land. Feet. I'm trying to level off here, but see, now my speed has dropped. I haven't touched the trim, so I want to drop. My airplane wants to fall because the trim tab wants, you know, 115. And as it get closer, you see it's easier and easier. But the idea with trimming out your airplane is you can do this. It's like cruise control, but instead of just turning it on, you actually have to play with it. But there's elevator trim, and then there's aileron trim, because you'll notice if I, you know, hands off, the plane will start to, P-roll? It's a torque roll, basically. The propeller is spinning this way. For you, it's this way. So the plane wants to go the other way, so it's going to twist this way, and that's just the nature of it. You see, it's starting to tip. It's very slow, but it definitely does it. So that'll rudder and aileron trim can help with that, but most general aviation aircraft only have elevator trim. Yeah, that's a thing. Microsoft Flight Simulator doesn't do it very well. Does not do it very well. I think I showed this once, but this is what I love about X-Plane. That's the flight model. So along the cord line, you can see you can see the lift vectors. Probably about 20 more minutes, Arctic. Not very long. I just wanted to test this up, but yeah, about 20 more minutes. You can see the strength of the lift, and even the wing spar there, strut there has some lift to it, and you can see it change. This is level flight because, you know, this side is equal to that side, but I can change that by deflecting my aileron, and you can see. If I bank right, which means this aileron goes down, it provides more deflection, more lift. If I go left, it goes up and provides less. Same with my elevator. Like so. And then you can see the propeller has its own, and if I slow down, it's kind of hard to see, but they do move. Looks like I'm in a descent, but I don't want that. So, is it M? Shift M? Nope, wrong button. Control M. No. Oh wait, is that what I think it is? Shift 8. Oh, I forget which one that is. So Control M, and this is the slipstream, the relative wind. So behind me, if there was somebody behind me, you would see, you know, there's a slipstream. If I go to the side, I think you can actually see it curl. Yeah, there we go. The relative wind, if you will. And then back to nothing. Okay. Well, there's the airport. Nice. Tonka. And I am fairly high, but I'm not terribly high. One of the things about flying is energy management. If you're a glider pilot, you're all about that energy. If you are a powered airplane pilot, energy is still of concern to you, but it doesn't engulf you. It is not every ounce of your flying. You're not aware of it all of the time. You should be, but most pilots are not. Energy management means basically what energy is. You have mass, you have potential energy, kinetic energy, your speed, basically, your altitude, your potential energy there. So I'm at, looks like 20, I'm coming down through 2,700 feet at about 95 knots. I need to get several thousand feet down, or 2,000 feet down. I'll catch you later, Arctic. Yeah, I plan to stream more. Now that I've got this set up the way that I want it, I need to get the next step is to work out how I want to do this. I have some ideas that I want to try, but I got to work them out. Once that happens, I'll be back. But I am pretty high and fairly close to the airport. And I might do some S-turns because I missed that runway. That's the airport straight in front of me. There are two runways at this airport, and they are small. Thanks, Arctic. I appreciate it. I'm glad they're fun. I enjoy doing them. I'm glad you like them. Ooh, excuse me. Here's the Cedar River. All right. Have fun, dude. Actually, I might do a short final and hit the other runway instead. Because this one's a ridiculously short runway. And I think I might be... Well, I'm coming down. I'm too fast, though. Way too fast. Since it's calm, I can do this. If it was windy, I'd actually have to basically do like a holding pattern. But thankfully, the winds are calm. I can do this. All right, 70 knots. It's a little slow for an approach, but we'll make it work. Again, it's calm. It's not going to suck the lift out from under me. ideally. Alright. Let's kill the throttle. Ah, turned too hard, too late. Good and high. Not what I wanted. Means I'm gonna pick up some speed here, which I don't want. Yeah, a little fast. Oh boy, I may not make it. Oh, that was horrible. Way too fast. This is interesting. There's a bump here. And whoop. And because I don't have rudder pedals with brake pedals, the brakes are either full max or not on at all. They're either on or off. It sucks. Speed bump, yeah. You should see it coming this way. Yeah, let me... Yep. Keep it on the runway. There we go. But yeah, I'll do a high speed taxi up to the bump. Yeah. Well, you know what? Let's imagine coming from the other side. Oh, my flap screwed me up there. And bump. My trim is... You want to go scare a semi-driver? Good stall right before the balloon. All right, let's get full flaps. Drop some speed. Let's crab it over to this runway. Come on. There it is. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Crab it in, just crab it in. Roop. That nose wheel down. Brakes. Stop. Ooh. There we go. Just a bit. Just a bit. Like I said, that's... The brakes are either on or off, and I'm not even sure if it's... I can check real quick. Joystick equipment. Buttons. Oh, sorry. It's hold brakes regular. So I think if I do... I can't do... Brake left, brake right, brake regular. Yeah. I guess I can't do full breaks. I can eject. Deploy flares, drop all tanks. Yeah, I can just brake regular. Because then... Yeah, that's the parking brake, so toggle brakes max effort on or off. Eh. Oh well. Let's, got about 10 more minutes. Let's do... Are these my V10s? Yeah. I thought I had a Super Cub. I just have a J3. These are fun. Oh crap, I start these things. Parking brake. Crap, I don't even know if I can start this thing. Alright, that's throttle. No, that's throttle. That's mixture. Where's the key on this thing? Engine primer. What's that? Cabin heat. Oh, don't tell me this is a... This is a hand prop one. And I don't know how to do that. Alright, let's try something else. Ooh, a champ. I can do a champ. Nope, wrong button. The prop is not, oops, wrong one. The prop is not, yeah, that's a horrible cockpit, but I think I can work with it. Mixture, crack the throttle. Am I missing something? Brakes are set. Why you no worky? Wow. How's it look on the outside? Oy vey. Maybe I should check these before. Looks very, very barren. Cause that's one of the downsides. I have it turned on to start the airplane cold and dark. There we go. So if I do this, there we go. That's better. I'm not gonna bother with a in cockpit view. Tail draggers are fun. Oh, this is gonna hurt. Yep. Yeah, it's like a little ramp. Whoa! Why'd that throw me off there? All right, keep it centered. Keep it centered. Keep it centered. Get some airspeed. There we go. There we go. That is a horrible cockpit. Absolutely horrible. I don't even want to look at that. The paint job's bleh. I mean, not that mine's any better. Not that mine's any better. This thing can get kind of fun. I really don't want to be in here, but... So this thing's slow flight is pretty awesome. So level flight. Slightly level flight, and I'm turning. I love doing that. slower I go. Losing altitude though, ever so slightly. I got to fly a version of the Champ, or I should say an evolution of the Champ, the Aranca Citabria. Interesting name, it's aerobatic spelled backwards. I don't think this plane has it, but the Citabria, because it was aerobatic, had inverted tanks. Not many planes out there, no they don't. You do that with a 747, you might break something. Let's get a little bit of altitude. Give myself a cushion, and we'll see if this thing's got inverted fuel tanks. Or inverted fuel pumps. And oil pump. Yep. Nope. Didn't lose that much altitude. It's about 400 feet. Not too shabby. Yeah, this ain't the aerobatic one. I have flown a Super Cub. Those are fun. I want one. I want one. Horrible cross country, but I mean, they'll do it. But they're just a fun little plane. Alright, side slip a little bit. Try and lose some altitude so that I'm able to bleed off some speed here. Just because this one's new to me. We'll do it this way. We'll cheat. Because I can. Carby suspected. Yeah, possibly. Come on, three point it. Nope. Oh, wait, second chance. Nope. Boing, 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 boing. Get that tail down, boy. There it is. Ideally, you want a 3-point land these and land in this configuration right here. All three wheels touch at the same time. If you don't, you risk hitting the prop because you're, you know, on your wheels, your mains. But that wasn't too bad. Not too bad at all. We'll just sit here like this because that looks better. No, right? Oh, excuse me. All right. Well, Max, thank you for joining me. I appreciate it. Short little stream. I'm glad it's working well, because I kind of want to get back into this. I think we're going to hop on WoW next, so I might see you there. If not, I do appreciate it. Thank you for coming out. Thank you for the feedback. And, I will catch you guys later. Take it easy. Bye! I gotta change that screen. Oh, he did? Okay. I'll probably hop on.